high altitude climbing. My brother, Frank Simmons, is one of the world's best. 3 days ago, Frank set off to climb Chomolungso with a climbing partner, Paul Ward. He's still up there. Somewhere. Frank and Paul were hired to make the climb by Edward Bennett, the famous expedition organizer. Bennett climbed with Hillary, Bishop, Messner, and most of the other gods of the mountaineering world. They were supposed to recover an ancient artifact that Bennett knew about, but after they found it, they had some sort of argument. Paul returned to base camp. A storm blew up, and now none of the Sherpas will set foot on the mountain they call the Sacred One. Bennett called me because I was nearby and already acclimatized. So, once again, it's Eric Simmons off to rescue his kid brother. I swear, if I find that stupid bastard alive, I'm gonna kill him. Climbing log, 16,800 feet. Lando is the highest city in the world, the gateway to the Himalayas. It's a religious city, ruled by the monks of the Chod sect of the Buddhist religion, and home to the intensely superstitious Sherpas, the toughest, most skilled climbing guides in the world. But now, this normally bustling city is deserted. The stores are shuttered, the streets bare. I had to bribe a truck driver to bring me here, and no amount of money could persuade him to actually enter the city. Something has caused the Sherpas to flee their beloved mountain, which will only make it harder for me to find my brother, Frank. Now, here I am, on the edge of a deserted city, desperately needing answers, and without a clue how to find Edward Bennett's house. So, situation normal, I guess. Completely screwed up.
Almost there.
Bloody hell. I'm below 17,000 feet, and acclimatized. Be hallucinating. A monk? I don't believe this. The monk gestures like a ritual. The ghost shrinks as if it's in pain. It's gone. Oh, this can't be real.
Real, Eric? What is real? That which you perceive is what forms your reality. You must learn about the third eye, the gateway to higher consciousness.
Hello, Mr. Bennett. It's an honor to meet you, sir. This is it. Bennett's place.
I tried to stop them, but Paul said Frank insisted on going higher, which is completely nonsense.
Something wrong here. Hard to concentrate on his voice.
The object is known as a terma. It's an ancient artifact. Very powerful. missing only 3 days, he may still be alive. To retrieve something personal, something Frank touched that was special to him. A man called Thod Parr will help you.
Bennett said he can perform a ritual to see if Frank is still alive. I have to find something Frank used and bring it back. Sounds like crap to me, but I don't have much choice. Either these ghosts are real, and your whole worldview just got knocked into a hat, or there's some kind of high-altitude hallucination. So, Bennett tried for the Tim. Lost his leg in an accident, and hired Frank to go after the Tim for him. And now he's been scared off by a ghost. So I guess it's time for me to get cracking and find that monastery.
Climber's log. 18,000 feet. Approaching the tiny village of Cherku, someone must still be here. Maybe someone who knows how to get to Thod Parr.
Prayer spears no longer protect. Bad place hurts ignorant. Cut through ignorance. Cut through illusion.
Frank Simmons, my brother. Do you know where he is?
He, your brother? That outsider? Ask woman lives above village. Jomo Menmo. Brings me food. Very powerful Yugini. Very holy.
Thank you. I'm most grateful. I'll go look for...
Stop! You're not ready. God through ignorance. Cut through illusion. Otherwise, die. Void, not harm, void.
Prayer spears. The shaman's trying to ward off evil. The shaman will know how to find Thod Parr.
Thank you.
fog. 18,000 feet. Suddenly, the same queasy feeling I had at Bennett's. Some kind of drugged incense. She asked for something that belonged to Frank. Muttering, murmuring. Her apprentice, Ming Mai Yangzi, performed rituals with Frank. Prepared him to climb the sacred one. Feeling woozy. Only Jomo Menmo can appease goddess. Badalamo's wrath. She says follow, but don't trust senses. Use inner eyes.
Through this alive, things will be different between Frank and me. We could be friends again. Jericho Village looks so peaceful. Everyone's dead.
Fight, spirit, and die!
ready for her this time. Some kind of ritual. Huge birds coming. Cutting begins. Caught in the bardo. The goddess is undecided. That's it then. Sounds like I'm in for some hard knocks. But if the goddess is still undecided, there's hope for Frank. Presuming I haven't gone stark raving mad.
Climber's log. 18,200 feet. I'm in the terraced fields above Cherku.
Close call. Those rocks.
Log. 18,400 feet. I'm heading for the Nien Diki Book Monastery.
Nien Diki Book Monastery. Looks peaceful from here. Something's not right. I hope Todd Pa is still alive.
Eric! It's Frank! Help me! Help me!
Welcome to the Nyendikibuk Monastery, young Eric. I have been expecting you. I fear your journey until now has been a confusing one. Perhaps I can make things clearer. A year ago, I was studying in the monastery library when a trick of the light revealed that the ancient manuscript I was reading was actually a palimpsest, a scroll that had been written on, scraped off, and used again. What lay underneath was a breathtaking discovery. The location of an ancient terma. A terma is a key piece of wisdom that was written down in ancient times and magically hidden until such future time as the wisdom is needed. Only then does the terma come again to the light. I could not decipher the entire scroll, and so I brought it to Master Lama Kenpo Jigme Lingpa for him to study. But in the meantime, I also told my good friend Edward Bennett what I had found, and that the terma lay waiting to be collected high on the Sacred One. Bennett could not wait for the remainder of the scroll to be translated. Impetuously, he embarked on a solo climb to retrieve the terma. He suffered a terrible accident that resulted in the loss of his leg. By the time Bennett had recovered, Master Kenpo had deciphered the rest of the text. It was a prophecy about the man who would bring the terma down from the mountain. When I read the prophecy to Bennett, he immediately said that the words applied to your brother. Bennett brought your brother here and prepared him to climb the mountain. There were mundane preparations, of course, but also sacred ones. Normally, one cannot climb Chomolonzo unless one has journeyed on foot around the base of the mountain 12 times. Such a journey is known as a kora. Of course, Frank had not completed these koras, but Bennett persuaded Jomo Menmo's apprentice to perform a series of sacred rituals that would appease the goddess and allow Frank to approach her. The apprentice was a young girl named Mingma Yangzi. Something must have gone wrong. The day after Frank left camp, ghosts and demons started to appear. The Sherpas fled. My fellow monks fled. They have run away from the goddess for the very reason that you approach her. They flee themselves. You approach yourself.
Thanks all the same, mate. But I don't believe in your goddess. I'm just here to collect my brother and move on.
You don't need to believe in her. You have been fighting these ghosts that you do not believe in, yes? They are only going to get stronger. And if you do not prepare yourself to approach the mountain, ultimately, these ghosts will defeat you. You think this is about your brother, and it is. But it is also about you. Not all ghosts wish you harm. Seek out the spirits of our departed lamas and learn what they have to teach you.
Oh. Abbott's buried here. Mummies. I need their mantras. Maybe record on tape.
Prepare yourself to face the terrible spirit that awaits inside the sanctum.
I think you should know. I'm not exactly a praying man.
Prayer is not necessary. Sit. Become calm. Enter within yourself. You will know when you are ready. You are ready to move on. But I have hard news for you. I believe your brother's spirit may have passed into the Bardo.
You mean he's dead?
Not exactly. It is possible for a spirit to return from the Bardo.
Dead's dead. But if his body's up there, I'm going to find it.
Do not give up on Frank yet. This scroll will introduce you to Master Lama Kenpo. He will tell you about the Bardo, how it might be entered, how a soul might be retrieved.
I don't believe a word of it, but thanks all the same.
Climber's log. 18,700 feet. Right below Dige Gonchen. Biggest monastery in the entire province. Library jammed with centuries of wisdom. But I need to find the abbot, Kengpo Jigme Lingpa. He's the one who will help me find Frank.
Now I'm going as mental as the rest of them. I could swear I had a vision of Bennett. If the bald chap turns out to be Kenpo, then I'll really be freaked out.
Certainly got that prophecy wrong, didn't you,
I've got a climber.
Dead on the mountain, and
no treasure to show for it.
The Terma has not left the mountain, so it is not for us to say yet whether the prophecy is true. As for treasure, the value of the Terma lies only in the wisdom it reveals.
Bollocks, you old fraud!
We both know the possessor of the Terma will become immortal. You can sit there on your ass and chant if you want.
I'm going to retrieve the Terma myself.
I know you're out there, Simmons. You want to fight ghosts while your brother freezes?
Fine. But I'm going back to base camp while there's still time. Paul might rescue Frank, even if you won't.
I recognize you. The vision. That's impossible.
Perhaps you are recalling a photograph of me that you saw when you met Togpa.
Maybe.
You were wise to avoid Bennett. You are not yet ready to ascend the Sacred One.
People keep saying that.
Sit with me. Meditate. I will teach you to enter the Bardo and learn the fate of your brother. The Bardo is the realm of the afterlife. It is the intermediate stage one passes through between death and rebirth. The first Bardo comes at the moment of death. If one is truly enlightened, one can enter Nirvana at that instant. Most souls pass into the second Bardo, which is divided into two parts and which lasts for 2 weeks. During the first 7 days, the departed soul encounters the peaceful deities. During the second 7 days, the soul meets the wrathful deities, hideous, terrifying demons who torture, howl, and scream. The soul who can remain calm and recognize that the wrathful deities are really the peaceful deities in disguise may pass to enlightenment. If the soul enters the third Bardo, it encounters the Lord of Death who passes judgment upon it using the mirror of karma. If the soul fails, it is drawn earthwards towards rebirth and yet another cycle in this world of sorrow. Your brother has used the power of the Terma to enter the Bardo while still alive. He is wandering in the nether regions, trapped between worlds, powerless to move either forward or backward. It is still possible for him to return to this life, to be reunited with his earthly body. But for him to do so, Eric, you yourself must enter the Bardo, search for your brother, and help him to return. Still time. Go, climb the Sacred One.
Climber's log. 19,300 feet. Nearly Jangrang La, the pass leading to Chomlo Lonzo base camp. Weather is holding. Got to go.
Go in!
Sexual.
You're beautiful.
Take Amulet to a lover.
summit. Almost there. Keep going. Can't. Cold. Walkie-talkie. Oh, still works.
Hello?
Who?
Someone out there?
Simmons.
Frank! My God.
Eric! Simmons!
You've got to be kidding me. Are you lost? I'll talk you in.
Thank you. asleep and you're dead. More coins. God damn it, they're everywhere. Yes, there it is. Straight ahead. Climb down there.
Mr. Bennett says you'll help with the rituals. Is that right?
Yes. I help. I am mountain. I am goddess. Rituals make you ready. Golden Lama, not gentle, not make her angry. Still now.
How many more rituals are there?
Almost all done.
I start the climb tomorrow.
Next ritual, last one.
At last, the final ritual. You're beautiful.
Please, no.
Stop. Now.
I cannot.
You bloody well can. You bloody well will.
I love a man. I no longer goddess. I not mountain.
I leave today. We're doing this whether you like it or not.
Finish or not, no matter. I not mountain. You need another. No, don't go. Begin again. Goddess not forgive.
What a bloody waste of time.
No.
You whore.
No. No, no, no.
Stop there.
Bennett. What are you doing out here? The Terma pole. Go back up and get it. No. There's another 1,000 in it for you. I can't. Eric Simmons is lost out there. I'm guiding.
Climber's log. 20,300 feet.
You seduced Mingma. She abandoned the rituals. When Frank went up there, it was like raping the goddess.
I didn't seduce her. We fell in love. You can ask her.
Her amulet. You killed her.
Now, Eric, you have the same choice as him. Fetch me the Terma or die.
God hell, you bastard.
Take
climber's log. 23,600 feet. Using oxygen now. Not enough at base camp. So I'm already low. More at high camp on Southwest Ridge. One make it there. Need another O2 bottle.
Hundreds of years it's been up here, just waiting.
Okay, let's start down. The storm is getting worse.
No, I'm going to summit.
Bennett's gonna kill me, Frank. He sent me up here to keep you safe.
Try to stop me, and you'll get hurt.
The goddess won't like this, Frank.
She won't like this at all.
Haven't changed. Headstrong. Just like me.
Frank! Frank! Frank!
He is not here.
Where the hell are you?
I am here. I am an Amato. Frank has entered the Varden. He is fighting his demons. Everyone must fight their demons ever. Even those who believe they have none, such as you. You think of Buddhism as a religion of peace. Did you never wonder why all our monks learned to fight? The curse is lifted. Go in peace.
Come on, Frank. Let's get out of here.
I'm not going.
Don't be an idiot. You're sick. We're both sick. It's the altitude. We'll get back down, and everything will be set right.
Why do we do it, Eric? Why do we climb mountains? Is it to get away from ourselves? Or to find our true self? My true self isn't pretty, Big Brother. I've learnt what I can from this life. It's time to move on and try again.
I'm bloody well not leaving you here.
You've always felt the weight, haven't you? The responsibility to take care of me. Eric Simmons to the rescue. Isn't that what you used to say? Well, you can lay that down now. You've done well. Mum and Dad would be proud. Goodbye, Eric.
Climbing log, 27,500 plus feet. I don't know how much of this is real, but I know Frank is where he belongs. Whatever the Terma is, the prophecy was wrong. The world is not ready for its power. I'll leave the goddess to protect her own.